Hey guys, it's Dr. Gussow here. I'm on the campus of the University of Mississippi, where I'm an associate professor of English and Southern Studies. In my spare time, I talk harp. Welcome to my Dirty South Blues Harp channel. Today, for this and the next lesson or two, I want to talk about a subject I haven't actually directly addressed. And it's one that I think almost all of you are interested in, either like talk about or underneath the surface you think about, which is the question of speed. What does it mean? What does speed mean to a contemporary modern blues harmonica player? And by the way, let me just apologize if it looks like I'm speaking from the crossroads. It's a hot mid-July day, midsummer day, and it's I'm backlit. Okay, so that's what's going on. So I want to talk about speed. I'm going to, one of the things that's been going on actually the last couple of weeks is I've had a handful of gigs, Satan and Adam gigs, and I've met a few of you out there on the hustings. We were in Greenwood, South Carolina last weekend, and the weekend before, we played here in Oxford, and we played in Clarksdale, Mississippi, we played in Tuscaloosa. I've got some footage. In fact, I've got a little cadenza that I'm going to put in at some point in this lesson. I'll probably indicate when I do that. In which I'm playing on a B-flat harp. And actually, I've been practicing a lot, and what intrigues me is the way in which the stuff that I'm practicing, which I don't practice a whole lot of the time when I'm not gigging, but when I gig, I practice because my butt's on the line. And I play fast stuff when I practice. That's one of the things I practice. What's interesting is the way that it ultimately works itself into your playing. So I don't want this thing to be just about talk. Let me just talk a little. Let's throw some names out there. Who are some blues harmonica players who are known for being really fast? Some names come to mind, and obviously, if you're not talking just blues, then a guy like Howard Levy, he plays fast, but he also does all the overblows. So that's a whole, like, that's the ultimate level in some ways, is a guy who's playing in all the keys, all the chromatic notes, and playing really fast. So if you can play full-fledged bebop jazz, so there's somebody. Now, on the next level, guys who are recognized as fellow mortals, but they're definitely quite a bit above me, would be my friend and pal Jason Ritchie, who's doing overblows. He's really pretty much playing tonally, but at least he was last year. Maybe this year he's beyond that. Carlos Del Junco is doing that. I think Chris Michalik is playing a lot of overblowy stuff. So there are a lot of overblowers out there. There are guys like L.D. Miller, who, young guy, but very, very fast. John Popper, Popper's Sugar Blue. Who are some other really fast players? Who are players known for speed? Randy Singer doesn't get enough respect in the blues, straight ahead blues harp community, but he's a kick-ass player. And there are others. I was thinking of posting a video calling myself kind of the, you know, top 10 over 50 players in terms of speed. I have a fair bit of speed when I want it, and it's something I practice. But let's talk a little bit about speed. What does it mean to have speed? Well, first of all, don't confuse the speed with which you can play scales with the speed with which you can make music or create. And yet, scales are important, but they're not the same thing. When I was a guitar player, you know, we were all into like really fast stuff. It's okay to do some of that on harmonica, but it's also important to kind of create the skill set for yourself, the speed by doing a bunch of scales that when the moment comes, you can improvise and throw stuff in. This is an incomprehensible lesson so far. So let me talk about a few different ways in which I use speed. Let me just go with what is intriguing me right now. Most of the stuff that I consider fast playing for me is stuff that I do in triplets. So I'm actually one of the faster triplet players out there. Now, Rob Paparosi, there's a buddy of mine from New Jersey, very fast triplet player. And of course, Jason can dance all over the thing. And so what would fast triplets be? Well, I have a warm-up exercise that I use, and I think I did this in an early lesson, which goes something like this. And that's coming off the 9-hole blow. This is a C harp, by the way. I'm going to work on a C mostly. So you're doing 6, 12 notes every bar. And I'm actually throwing a little bit more than a triplet in one of those places, right? But one of the practice routines that I might make would be at a moderately fast tempo to try to keep inventing and play my way through a 12-bar blues. So something, and not stop, okay? So you can do repeated notes. I'm just going tut 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 tut, right, with my tongue on the roof of my mouth. Of course, in order to play fast triplets in a blues context, you need to know the blues scale and need to know, I think, for all the way from the 1-hole draw up to the 10-hole blow. Let me see if I can do a riff that would go all the way to up and down. So I'm going to play a 12-bar blues. Let's try that again. Now notice, I like to interrupt. I don't just want to play triplets. If you play triplets, you're a machine gun, you're not a musician. So here's a key point about speed, is that it's much more effective, if you've got speed, to know also when to just hold a note. So in your practice, for anything I talk about in the future, when you're practicing speed, make sure that at some place in your practice routine, you're practicing moving from, let's say, fast triplets to one note held for a long time in the middle of the sequence. Now, this may come out at some point, but here's a totally different kind of thing to think about. And it's something that I managed to execute to my stunned surprise when we were doing a song called Heartbreak. And I'm going to post this video, I think, after this one, because it's playing on a C harp. I'm doing a lot of overblows, but I also did a double octave leap. I did a sequential octave leap. I want to show you something interesting. It sort of falls in the category of speed, but mostly it's about the speed of movement from one end of the harp to the other, which is not the same as machine gun notes. Let me interrupt myself, and I see I'm at 9 minutes already, to say make one more really, really important point in this lesson. We're going to go on. I want to do some lessons on speed. Repeated licks. That was the other thing. So we're going to move from the bottom to the top, but it's also important to have some licks like this. That's the end of this lesson. Let's move on to lesson number 2. I hope I whetted your appetite for this stuff. Coming right back at you. Bye-bye.